Hey, how's it going out there? Today I want to talk to you about something that I don't see on a lot of e-biker bicycles. I'm always a little amazed and frankly concerned when I see people taking their e-bikes out on rides to the outback country with absolutely no tools or repair kits. And really, even on some of the in-town rides with the weight of an e-bike, it's gonna be pretty hard to push it back to the car, and you can forget about trying to carry it back. Also, I don't know of any outback country Uber or Lyft services. And even in town, it's sometimes hard to get a ride back that will accommodate your e-bike. To me, it just makes sense to carry some sort of repair and or toolkit on your e-bike no matter where you ride. Here's the deal. Even if you're not able to repair a flat or some other simple repair on your bike, you know, you have the repair kit there so you can flag down someone to help you that can use your repair kit. And I can tell you, I always stop when I see a cyclist in distress. And there have been numerous times that I've stopped and the cyclist, whether it be an e-bike or a regular cyclist, had a flat but no repair kit. And so I was able to use mine to help them get them on their way. That's why I think it's really, really important to always carry a repair kit and other particular tools to your bike. So when you do break down and when you do need help, at least you'll have the right repair parts for your bike, like tubes, wrenches, and any other bike-specific parts. Now, I know on a regular bike, you try to keep the weight down, but on an e-bike, you know, the reality is weight isn't really an issue. So I carry a few extra things in my kit, and I want to show you what I carry so I can be self-sufficient, whether it's in the backcountry or just in the urban or suburban areas. Now, me, personally, being a retired engineer, I'm a little anal with the stuff that I carry. But you can kind of make your own judgments on your kit, but you really need to have something. And let me show you what I have. I used to carry the CO2 cartridge tire pump up, but I found, especially with the fat tires, that it takes two or even three cartridges to pump it up. Plus, when you go to use your cartridge, you find that it's empty. So I wanted something easy and reliable. So that's why I have a portable air compressor. It's USB rechargeable. I carry a USB cord and it works pretty good and it saves me from having to pump. Of course, I carry a tube so I can easily change it if I get a rip in the tube. And I do carry a tire patch kit, actually two of them. And I have $5 and some change in there just in case for whatever reason I'm without my wallet. Carry a USB cord so I can recharge my compressor using the bike battery, or a phone for that matter. Various Allen wrenches, all kinds, probably more than I need, but like I said, being a little anal. Of course, I carry various tire irons. Well, three of them are plastic, one's metal. I carry a couple of chain links and a chain breaker. And I throw a multi-tool in there for good measure. I have a professional looking grease rag, a mechanic's rag. And recently, a new addition to my toolkit is a bunch of zip ties. You just cannot believe how handy these things are. And I carry a number of extra Velcro ties, bungee cords, and just general ties. You know, you might want to stop by the taco shop, pick up a few burritos. And you'd be surprised at how compact this stuff really is once you get it into your bike bag. I mean, my bike bag is pretty small. Now, in addition to my toolkit, I carry a few other basic items, like a basic first aid kit and pepper spray. And another video, I'll show you some of those extras that I carry. But for now, it's the old graybeard e-bike rider saying, let's hit the road and let's roll. See you later.